Senator Gardner.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you for being here today. It's great to have a University of Colorado graduate testifying before the panel, so welcome. Just wanted to follow up with some of the conversations we had in my office. Yesterday, we did have a hearing, Senator Cardin and I, with Jason Foley, the Deputy Assistant Administrator for the agency. It was a good conversation. One of the things that we talked about is just where priorities are for the Asia-Pacific region. If you could just spend a little bit of time talking about that, I would appreciate it.
Yes, and I think the greater emphasis on Asia has been reflected in an increase in resources and personnel. As we discussed the other day, I think there's some other things that we can explore in Asia, and I'm interested in the reference to trade capacity building. That is one of them. I think that's something aid makes huge contributions to around the world, whether it is at the level of petty trade, local trade, national, regional, or in fact global trade. What I would like to do, if confirmed, and Senator, I would love to work with you and others on this, is do more in Asia of what aid has done very well in other parts of the world. And that is to help work on the constraints to private capital flows and increase private capital flows in support of development in Asia. That's number one. Number two, work with governments, again, to build on what aid's done to date, to build the capacity to run and sustain economies that are inclusive and deliver for their citizens. I think there's a lot that we can build out on, some of it aided by resources, which are critically important, as you have pointed out, some of it by taking the lessons the agency's learned in other initiatives in other parts of the world and applying them more effectively there. So these are all things I think we can do. I'm quite interested, as I say, I've got less experience in Asia than in other parts of the world, in consulting with you and with others, and obviously our men and women in the agency here in Washington, but particularly those in the field, to see what more can be done.
Thank you. And last year, the GAO, the Government Accountability Office, produced an assessment of USAID's trade policy, trade capacity building efforts, and concluded, and I'll quote the report, the U.S. Agency for International Development's 2003 trade capacity building strategy does not directly guide TCB activities, and parts of the strategy no longer reflect the current TCB environment. If confirmed, do you plan to update the TCB strategy?
Yes. I think that's something, Senator, I've worked with aid on this in my current capacity, and I think aid's learned a great deal. One of the things aid has also, I think, done a phenomenal job over the last few years is, again, taking those lessons and then figuring out how to apply them. So I think that could be a very, very good exercise.
Thank you. And we would love to follow up with you on some of the ideas for doing just that.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Chairman, thank you.